Hello friends, welcome to Java Coding Skill. Today I am going to discuss about HTML headings and how to create a web page using the HTML. So HTML headings. HTML heading tag can be defined as a title or a subtitle of web page. When you place the text within the tag like H1, it will display in the browser on the bold format and size of the text is depend on the number of heading. There are 6 different HTML heading which are defined with the H1 tag to H6 tag. The highest level of tag is the H1 and the least level of tag is the H6. The HTML H1 to H6 element represent the 6th level of the selection or the section heading. So H1 is the largest heading tag and H6 is the smallest heading tag. H1 is used for most important heading and H6 is used for least important heading. First of all, we should not resize any heading tag whatever we are giving on a page. If it is really required, then we can go for the CSS property like font size. Using the CSS property, we can resize the font size. We always follow the label of the heading tag. Suppose first we are writing the H1 tag, then we should write the H2. Similarly, we have to proceed. We should not to jump like first we can write the H1 tag, then we can go for the H4 tag. If we are going in a label, then it will easy to navigate and it looks good also for the representation. In every HTML page, there should be a one title will be there that will describe about the HTML content or about the page content whatever we have. We should not use multiple H1 tags in a page. It doesn't gives you any error on that, but it not looks good and it is not part of the best practice. So we should always use this one H1 tag in a page. You always have book always has a one title. You can't see a book with the multiple titles or you can't see a movie with the multiple titles. So everything whatever we are saying, there is at least one title is there that will describe about that feature whatever we have in that one. And H1 tag is most important for the improving the performance and the design. So if we improve the performance, it will improve the performance for the searching the results in the search engine. Here is the syntax of the heading tag. First tag is the H1 tag, second is the H2, then H3, H4, H5 and H6. So here we have all the tags like 6 tags of heading. Just we are writing the tag inside the angle bracket and the closing angle bracket. Now how to create a web page with the heading tags. Today I discussed about the heading. So I am using the heading tags in my first web page. We can start with the any tag. We can come in the upcoming videos. Then you will get more idea about the tags. So first of all, I am going to open the notepad. Here I open a notepad file. You can use your choice of editor, but if you are a newcomer, you don't know anything about the HTML or programming, then it is better you can go for the notepad only, because in this one you are writing each and everything with your hand. You are not getting any predefined suggestion from the editor, so it will be easy to learn for you. I am starting writing here. Doctype always will be the first element of the any web page whatever we are writing. Now I am going to the root element. As in yesterday video or in the previous video, I will describe about the file structure of the HTML page. In every web page there are certain HTML tags that should be represent in that file, like the doc type, HTML, then head tag, body tag. Inside the head tag we can give the title, about the CSS linking, and the keyword description in meta tags. Here I am using the title, my first page. Now I start using the tag. First tag is the H1 tag. This is the most important tag and the main heading. This is first heading, then H2. Here you can also practice with me. Whatever I am writing here, you can also write the same thing in your systems, and you can do start practice on this, how to create a first web page using the HTML tag. This is H3, then H4 and H5. So this is fifth heading, and the last is the H6. So this is sixth heading. Okay, so in this web page I write all the heading tag inside the body tag. So every tag have some predefined font size will be there, and every heading tag have the bold effect. So that I will show you in the output how it is coming, and describe about the each element font size. Now I am going to save this file. Here by default the text file is there, so it is showing the .txt extension. Now I have to change the type as to the all files, and I have to give the name of first page .html. .html is the extension of each and every HTML file. If we are giving the .html extension, then only the browser know this is the HTML file, and it will run on the browser. So now I save it. Now I open the same file in a browser. So here my output is displayed on the browser. Just I have to run the file in any browser. Just go to that file and click that file. Now you can press to the F12 and inspector window will open, and here I will show you the style of or font size of the each element. Here I am selecting the H1. So H1 is have the some predefined property and some predefined font size. So what is, we can see what is the font size is there. Font size is the 32 pixel for this H1 heading, and also here we have some space or before and after the heading text, whatever we are displaying. Now I am going to select the H2 tag. H2 tag have the font size is the 24 pixel, and H3 have font size nearby 18 pixel. It is not the exactly 18, but it is nearby that. And H4 have the font size is the 16 pixel. H5 has the font size is nearby 13. And H6 has the font size near to the 10. And it have the equal spaces for all the tags. Okay, now I am using this tool, but in the last I will explain you the how can we use this developer tool and what is the advantage of using that tool. Just here I am using to show you what is the font size for the each element we have, that is the predefined font size. So I think you are good to know. By creating the HTML first web page, Just go and start coding with the HTML first. If you really like this video, please do like, share and subscribe. So thank you for watching.